big dream happening today.
These kids from a summer camp near Aspen, Colorado, are about to give Amanda Boxtel a life-changing gift.
Hi, Amanda.
Hi.
It's a gift that will help her do something she hasn't been able to do here since she was paralyzed in a horrific skiing accident 21 years ago.
And now I want to invite the kids to just have at it and rip into it.
It's a bionic robot called EKSO. A battery-powered external skeleton that gives her legs the power to do this.
Are you ready?
Three, two, one, blast off!
Demo!
And this.
I'm walking, you guys!
And even this. The technology is so cutting edge that Amanda is the first person in the United States to own one.
The moment she stood up, I was just amazed because she's been sitting down for 21 years, and that first feeling to stand up again, it's just, I would have been thrilled to be in that position.
It was an emotional moment for these kids, who spent the past year selling countless cups of lemonade and raising money from generous donors to make it happen.
That was like my dream right there. All I wanted to see was her walk. It was amazing.
For Amanda, it was the culmination of a dream she's had ever since she was told she'd never walk again.
Probably the most profound moment was when I stood up and I tried to see the children's faces. And some of them, the really little ones, they were just in awe. And then to have that heart-to-heart hug. When I hug in a wheelchair, there's a disconnect. And that's, I get heart-to-heart hugs when I stand up.
Can you promise me a standing hug later?
Yes.
Okay, good. Amanda took her first steps towards making that dream a reality in 2010. That's when she got a call from the robot's creators, asking her to become a test pilot for their new technology. She traveled to their headquarters in the San Francisco Bay Area and took it for a test run.
How did it feel to be able to stand and just look at people?
First time I stood up, I went home and I cried hard, in all honesty. You know, these were emotions that I had been dreaming about for so long. And I felt so good in my body. I slept hard, and I wasn't in pain.
Total ending steps?
4,850.
So, nice.
The technology is fast moving, and they're constantly coming up with something new. That's why I love flying back to California and saying, okay, bring it on. What am I gonna try today?
This is EKSO's headquarters, where the magic is made and perfected. Here, robots like this are put through their paces, all to give people who are paralyzed a chance to do what they've been told was impossible.
I feel like the luckiest man alive. I mean,
Nathan Harding is a co-founder of EKSO BIONICS and one of the robot's inventors. It was first developed not for the health field, but for the battlefield, as a device to help soldiers carry heavy loads long distances.
There's a huge problem in the US military right now with soldiers getting injuries due to the large loads they're carrying, and in fact, they want to carry even more. So we were helping develop exoskeletons to carry the weight of someone's backpack and the weight of their vest as well.
Harding says the key breakthrough was creating a wearable robot that could support its own weight with a minimum of energy. That means it can be powered by a small battery pack. And then there's that whole walking thing.
And it takes over the function of the muscles in your legs. And it can do that either completely for like a person who's completely paralyzed below the waist, or it can do it partially for someone who's maybe trying to relearn how to walk, like someone who's just had a stroke.
So the only thing I have to do is initiate the first step.
Like Amanda, Jason Geezer is an EKSO test pilot.
I put the device in walk mode, and then take the first right step, and then as I move my body, the EKSO will move with me. But if I stop and I don't go to the next position, the EKSO stops. Hmm. So then I can just move forward and lateral, and there we go. We're walking again.
In 2008, his spinal cord was injured in a motorcycle accident that almost killed him. Jason says he found out he was paralyzed in a dream he had while he was in a coma. It was his girlfriend, Karen, who delivered the news.
And her message said this, almost verbatim. Hey, baby, it's me. You were in a bad motorcycle accident, and the doctors say you'll never walk again. If this isn't the life that you want to live, we understand and we'll let you go. But if you want to stay and fight, I'll be here with you. I could hardly ever tell that story without tearing up. But I knew that I have always been a fighter, so I wasn't going to give up.
EKSO helped him battle to defy the odds.
The first time I stood up in EKSO was just ridiculous. It was amazing. So many emotions are kind of going through. You have your fear of, I haven't stood and walked, really walked, and it had been over 2 years. And there's excitement, like you're getting ready to like blast off to space.
Test pilots like Amanda Boxtel and Jason Geezer, how have they helped you guys advance this technology?
Oh, they've helped immensely because everything is unpredictable once you introduce a human into the system. I remember being in the room with 13 PhDs and they all had a different idea of what would be the exact way to control something. Without people like Amanda and Jason, I mean, we'd really be at a standstill because we couldn't test anything.
The first time I used the EKSO, the physical therapist was the only one that had control. So they would monitor my body position and take the step when they felt that my body was in a safe and accurate position for walking.
All right.
And Daryl wouldn't walk you into a wall or anything cruel like that?
He would try. But I know he cares because he catches me when I get off balance.
While EKSO has pushed the boundaries of what is possible, the robot still has its limitations. Right now, it can only be used in a rehabilitative setting with a trained physical therapist.
You ready?
I'm ready, yep.
And then there's the price tag, from $110,000 to $140,000. EKSO BIONICS hopes the Food and Drug Administration will approve the device for home use, which could increase demand and decrease price.
There's nothing about this device that should make it any more expensive than, say, a high-end motorcycle. And we just have to get to those kind of quantities in production, and we can drive the cost down substantially. And then we can make it more accessible.
You want another hug? Get a little closer. There.
Oh, I don't get enough of these heart-to-heart hugs.
Well, if you need another hug, I'm your man.
All right.
All right.
Thank you.
I don't know.
Hi.
Since it was first introduced, EKSO has helped people who thought they'd never walk again take more than 3 million steps.
That's the best part. Push it away.
And not just test pilots like Amanda and Jason, but patients in more than 40 hospitals and physical rehabilitation centers around the world.
This one spasms a lot, and I think it's the hamstring.
I think it's coming from your calf.
Oh,
but
is it?
It's coming from your foot.
Oh,
watch. You want to watch? Here we go.
Oh.
Some of those centers are investigating whether walking with EKSO can improve the health of people who would otherwise be bound to a wheelchair.
Most people don't understand is that when a person gets a spinal cord injury, they typically cost the healthcare system $4.6 million over their life after they have their injuries. And the reason why is they're constantly getting rehospitalized for an array of things that mostly have to do with life in a wheelchair.
And sometimes with my neuropathic nerve pain, which is common for individuals with spinal cord injuries, sometimes on a scale of 1 to 10, it's an 11. And I live with that. I live with that every day. And when I walk, it dissipates.
The more frequent I walk and the more time I'm up, I experience better digestion of my food. I experience better bowel and bladder function.
While researchers study the robot's impact on health, it's clear EKSO's impact on the life of a person who is paralyzed can be extraordinary. The next best thing to a miracle. For Jason Geezer, EKSO meant he could walk with Karen the day he made her his wife.
And she walks to me and we turn and we walk down to get married together. And so it was the most amazing day. I mean, I can't even put words to describe how important it was for that day to happen just like that.
For Amanda Boxtel, it meant she could take a stroll with the ski patroller who saved her life 21 years ago.
Hal Hartman was the first person at my accident site. He came to see me walk, and that was pretty special because he looked at me in my eyes, standing up eye to eye, and he said, I never knew that you were this tall. He said, I always, for 21 years, have imagined what it might be like to look at you standing up eye to eye. And we did that.
And there it was. Wow.
And we walked.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.